it's Adria. Oh my gosh, I feel like it's been so long since I've said that. It's been like a month. Even though I've still been posting, it's been like a month since I've sat down and filmed a video. Alright, so I have a little bit of a story for you guys today. And this happened while I was away on my trip. I'm still so excited about this. I just can't believe that this happened. So, it's a story about how I met a couple of my fans, viewers, I don't know what you want to call them. They said they were my biggest fans, so I guess if they want to call themselves fans, I don't like using the word fans, but people that watch my videos, basically, viewers, subscribers, whatever you want to call them. I met a few of them, and it was so incredible, and it's a really, really funny story. I got some questions on my Instagram. Was this a meet and greet? If you saw the picture of me with the group of girls, no, it wasn't a meet and greet. It was totally unexpected. Out of the blue, okay? So here's what happened. It was Veterans Day. My stepfather is a teacher at a middle school, and he was also in the Navy. So he put together like this Veterans Day assembly thing where he like spoke and stuff. So my mom was like, do you wanna go with me to go watch him speak? I'm like, yeah, sure, why not? A while back, my stepdad had told me that a few of his students knew who I was, and I was like, no, like really? Cause I think one of them said to him, like, don't be a sad panic. He's like, oh, that reminds me of my stepdaughter. She does YouTube videos. And they were like, oh my gosh, I love her. I was like, oh my gosh, like, that's crazy that some of your students know who I am. So that's like, cool. So I woke up at the crack of dawn, you know, getting ready for school like I used to do. It felt so weird getting ready before the sun came out. I'm like, wow, I really feel like I am going back to school. Then when my mom and I were like on our way there, she was like, what if some of his students that recognize you see you? And I was just like, oh my gosh, like that made me kind of nervous. I didn't really look that good that day. I like barely got any sleep, got like 6 hours of sleep, just hot mess. Ugh, just not my best look, girl. So we get there, we get like our visitor stickers, we get to the auditorium. We're a little bit late, he's already like kind of speaking. After the assembly and everything, then he had to go teach his class. So my mom and I were like, oh, we'll just stick around for a little bit. You know, we kind of wanted to like see him teach because we've never really seen him teach before. So he said that we could like sit in the back of his classroom and just like watch his class. When we get to the classroom, he was like, oh, this is my wife and my stepdaughter. And he says, you might know her from YouTube. She's Don't Be a Sad Pan on YouTube. And then I get a bunch of seventh graders looking at me like, he pointed out the girls that knew who I was. He was like, she knows you, she knows you. And they're like, I'm your biggest fan. My mom was whispering to me, she was like, now they're looking you up. I can see them looking you up. And I was like, oh my gosh. And then I just look and I see my channel on like little screens and I'm just like, oh my, like that is so embarrassing. If you do YouTube videos and somebody has played any of your videos while you're around, it's so embarrassing. And I don't know why. I have no problem with all the people that watch my videos. I have no problem with that, but I don't want to be in the room when you're watching them. Just, it's all such a blur because I was so tired. I was so tired and I was so like caffeinated. I was like jittery and caffeinated. So I'm trying to remember the best I can. They were doing like presentations that day. So I actually got to like watch like their presentations. So the two girls that knew who I was, they kind of like were telling like other people about who I was. And then there were two other girls that just kind of like hopped on the bandwagon. Like, oh my gosh, like, whoa, a YouTuber in our classroom, so we're just gonna hop on the, you know, bandwagon here, you know, which I feel like is something I would have done, you know, if there was somebody that other people recognized, I'd be like, who is that? And then they would tell me and show me, and then I'd be like, whoa, okay, that's cool. I feel like that would have been me in that scenario, so. And then the two girls that knew me were like asking for my autograph. Oh my gosh, I've never given an autograph before. And I felt so bad because like my hand was like shaking because I was so jittery. Like I wish I hadn't had coffee that day so that I could have signed properly, you know. I was like so like my nerves on top of it, just trying to sign when you're nervous and you're caffeinated and you're just like, I'm sorry for the faulty signatures. As I'm like signing this, I'm like, I'm signing an autograph in a classroom right now. I signed four of them all together. I signed four autographs. And then the one girl, Isabella, she was like, oh, can I take a picture with you? And she like ran and got her phone and she came in the back of the classroom, was taking a picture with me. And then my stepdad, their teacher, he was like, okay, if you want to take pictures, like go out into the hallway while the other kids are presenting their projects. I'm like, okay, cool. all right. Me and these two other girls, we like go out into the hallway, we're like taking pictures. So first it was just me and the two girls who were actually subscribers. And then another girl came out of the classroom and then she was like just kind of asking me like about my YouTube and stuff. And she thought that it was really cool. So she kind of wanted to be included with it. So she like wanted pictures. Then the other girl, she was like already out in the hallway. Then she like joined us. We were just like talking about YouTube and stuff. So we kind of took a group picture right here. And yeah, so then they were like, well, could we be in your video? I'm like, well, I don't have my camera. They're like, well, you could like film it on your phone. I'm like, okay. I was even gonna bring my camcorder too, but it wasn't charged and I had like videos on it. And I just forgot to bring it. And I forgot to empty it off and charge it and bring it. I didn't think I would need it, you know, to be honest, you know? So I will play now the small, it's only like a 20 second clip we took in the hallway at the school with the group of girls, so play that now. All right, here's some girls that know who I am. You can introduce yourself if you want.
I'm Brooke.
I'm Isabella.
And I'm Juana.
And I met them at school, and I'm in middle school again, so I'm like, how old are you, 13?
I'm 12.
Yeah, so I'm like 12 today, so yay, this is awesome. So it was awesome meeting you guys. This is so great.
Hi.
And you'll be in my video. All right. They are so sweet. They were like the sweetest girls ever. And I feel like they think that I'm a bigger deal than I actually am. You know, it was so humbling. Until something like that ever happens to you, you don't really realize, you know, how big of a deal you are to people, because I knew that, you know, young girls looked up to me and like me and watch my videos and stuff, but like I actually got to meet some of them, and that was really, it put a lot of it into perspective for me, the people that actually watch my videos and, you know, the impact I have on them, because I'm a big deal to them, you know. And, you know, maybe on YouTube with the amount I have, I'm probably not that big of a deal, but for them it was a big deal. And I can see where that would be kind of cool, you know, like if I was in school and somebody that I actually knew from the internet was in my classroom, I'd be like, whoa. Even if they weren't super popular, super famous, super whatever, that would still be pretty cool. So I can imagine where that would be pretty cool. And you know, they said I was their favorite YouTuber, and so like if my favorite YouTuber was sitting in my classroom watching me present a project in front of the class, like I would just die. Die from anxiety and die from like, oh my gosh, is this really happening? Then later my mom and I were like, can you imagine them going home and being like, Mom, guess what? I met my favorite YouTuber at school today. I would just be like, what the heck? It was so bizarre, and I couldn't believe it. And then one of them asked me, are you going to other middle schools today? I'm like, no, just here. I guess they thought like I was like doing like meet and greets, meetups, like at other places. Like, no, this is purely coincidental. I just came here because my stepdad works here and I wanted to see him give a speech and stuff. So shout out to Lana, Isabella, Brooke, and Emma from a middle school. I don't want to say the name because you're minors. So my mom is like, you should give them a shout out. I'm like, well, they're, so I don't think I can like, you know, say their school and whatever, but yeah. So that was really cool. Other kids in the class were like asking me questions, what YouTubers I knew. Someone was like, oh, do you know Roman Atwood? I was like, yeah, I know Roman Atwood. And then this boy turns around real quick. He's like, wait, you know him? No, like I don't know him. I watch his videos. Although that would be kind of believable because I think he is from like Philadelphia around there, so it would have been believable. I could have been like, yeah, so I won't even collab with him either because he won't pay me enough. Like, I don't even know what to say about this. This experience was so nice. If you girls are watching this, it was so nice to meet all of you. You guys were just so sweet. You know, I know I'm not that big of a deal. You don't have to tell me. I said it the entire day after I left. I said to my mom, I'm like, Mommy, like, I'm not that big of a deal. Why are they freaking out so much? And she's like, well, to them, you're a big deal. I was like, okay. Now I'm gonna write a YouTuber book called I'm Not That Big a Deal. Big of a deal. Big a deal. Not that big of a deal. I don't even know how to say that right. And then when their class was over, the two girls that were like my subscribers gave me this paper with like all their like usernames and stuff on it. And they gave me their phone numbers too. And I said to my mom, I was like, I don't think I should be texting them. I feel like that would be kind of weird. I'll like follow you on Instagram. I'll follow you, you know, on Snapchat. With texting, it's risky. Don't be offended that I didn't text you. I've had my number get to places I haven't wanted it to be. So, you know, I just wouldn't want it to like escape and get somewhere that it shouldn't be. So I'm kind of careful with who I text and who I call and stuff like that. So sweet. And that was probably one of the greatest moments of my life. Like if I could pick like a top 10 priceless moments of my life, that would probably be one of them because it was so unexpected. It's not like I had like scheduled a meet and greet, scheduled a meetup. Like, no, it was completely just, I was just there for Veterans Day. And I said to my stepdad, he's like standing there in his captain uniform. I'm like, you're supposed to be the big deal today, not me. You're putting all the attention on me. Put it back on yourself. I feel like I'm forgetting details. I feel like I'm just forgetting stuff. The one girl, Lana, she was like, oh my gosh, I have to sit down. I have to sit down. Like, she was getting like her phone ready to take a picture when we were on the hallway, and she just had to like sit down on the board. She was like, I have to sit down. I can't believe this. I asked Lana if she could take a picture of me and Isabella. I was like, could you just take a picture of us? And I gave her my phone. She's like, I'm holding your phone. I'm holding your phone. The only way I can describe it is humbling. Just so humbling, and it really makes me appreciate you guys so much more. There are people out there that feel that way about me, you know. This isn't just all fake on a computer, you know. It isn't just numbers on my screen. Like, it's actual real people that watch me. And I want to say thank you to those girls that I met, and thank you to those of you who I haven't met yet that have wanted to meet me. And this has really got me thinking about meetups. And then my mom was like, oh my gosh, we should totally organize a meetup. Like, it got my mom so excited. My mom was like, and one of the girls asked my mom if she was my manager. My mom was like, she wishes. My mom got so excited. She's like, no, next time you come up, we have to do a meet and greet with, like, you know, and I'll take the pictures and it'll be fun. Like, where can we do it? Can we do it at our house? I'm like, no, like, we can't do it at your house. No. Definitely, I'll be considering doing meetups. The two definitely that will happen probably first is Orlando and Philadelphia. So leave a comment down below. I know I've asked this before, but leave a comment down below if you're near either one of those, Philly or Orlando, and if you would be willing to come and see me. Obviously, I wouldn't charge tickets for it. It would just be free. It would just be, you know, come and take a picture with me and hug me and talk about life and food and stuff like that. So yeah, definitely leave a comment if you would come to that. Yeah, definitely be thinking about that, because that's exciting. And I feel like meeting like a couple viewers of mine really got me inspired to do meet and greets. I feel like until you actually meet somebody that watches you, you kind of don't really believe that it's real, if that makes any sense. You know, like, it just, like, it feels like it's all on your computer. Once you turn your computer off, like, close my laptop screen, like, it's not there anymore. No, like, it's real life. There are people that watch me. There are people that know who I am. So once again, thank you to those middle school girls. And they made me feel really old. I was like, oh, you guys are like, what, like 13, 14? They're like, we're 12. I'm like, I'm 10 years older. I'm 10 years older than you. So yeah. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. I hope I can meet all of you guys. I want to meet every single one of you and just hug you and give you advice and tell you that life is going to be okay. And yeah, if you're not already subscribed, because I put out videos 3 times a week, I promise. I miss Saturday, but that's okay. I'm making up for it now. Panda hugs. I love you guys.